just only one number because of the brevity of time. And then, Rachel, you will follow, you'll give us a number, and then we will continue. Shall we open with a word of prayer? Almighty God, we want to thank you. We want to bless you because you are everlasting. And in you we live, we walk, and we have our being. Jehovah, we bless you because you have made this possible. I give you praise. I give you honor. Heavenly Father, even as you partake this meal of praising you and worshiping you, we want to glorify your name. We want to ask your Shekinah glory to be here. Father, I want to thank you because of bringing our guests from far and wide. We want to declare, Father, Lord of glory, that this is your house where all nations shall come and kneel down and get their breakthrough. Heavenly Father, accept our praise, accept our worship. Everything that you shall take praise here, let it be to your glory. In Jesus' name we say, Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Are you ready to praise? We're going to sing two really hot ones. Amen. And I need everyone's help. Yeah? So we are all in this together. Amen. I will lift up your name. I'm gonna lift up your name. Oh, Jehovah, you are wonderful.
I will lift up your name.
I'm gonna lift up your name. I'm gonna lift up your name.
My children go double double. My everything a double double.
Ewe ni Mungu, mwenye nguvu zote, nani ula kwa mfano wako, na umbike, nikiyatizama, nguvu zako kweli za ajabu. Ewe ni Mungu, unjua yote, ni mwangaza Mungu ni mwangu, nikitembea, wanitizama, nyenendo yangu yote wayajua. Wema wako wanitosha, fadhili zako zanitosha. Nimeona nguvu zako, umenilinda na kushukuru. Nipitapo kwenye giza totolo, nipa hapo kama ndege angani. Nijifichapo chini ya maji, upo pote Bwana wanitizama. Umenilinda kwa nguvu zako, umenilinda
kinywa chako umeniokoa kwa nguvu zako umenidumisha kwa wema wako wanitosha fadhili zako zanitosha nimeona nguvu zako umenilinda na kushukuru wema wako wanitosha fadhili zako zanitosha nimeona nguvu zako umenilinda na kushukuru
Pira makofi, pira makofi
Umeni mwanya kwa nguvu zako Ewi mungu jafarafa Jumini wako, imari yako Chochote ni nacho, nitako mwana Na kushukuru, wana wa mamwana Na kuinua, nina kuinuki Unasahili, mungu wa miungu Wema wako, wana wanitosha Fadhili zako zanitosha Nimeona nguvu zako Umenilinda na kushukuru Wema wako wanitosha Fadhili zako zanitosha Nimeona nguvu zako Umenilinda na kushukuru Wema wako wanitosha Fadhili zako zanitosha Nimeona nguvu zako Umenilinda na kushukuru
God bless you so much.
Thank you, my sister, for such a wonderful song. I can feel you are a lean place and worshiper, and we have been highly blessed by your song that says that the goodness of the Lord is sufficient for us. So at this moment, or this time, we are going to the, calling the man of God, our dear pastor, a pastor that we know for many, many years, a pastor who had been highly dedicated in the work of God, a pastor that had been training for many, many years to do the work of God. He has actually trained over 17 years, and he is tested in the work of God. And this is a pastor that who is just about to come, the one that has really invited one, Pastor Kimani. He is a good friend of mine, and I'm happy that God have divinely connected myself with him, because he is a real model for the work of God. And I'm sure we don't have a lot like him. He is among the few remnant that we have today. And I'm highly inspired by him, by his commitment and the devotion of the work of God. And I'm sure that the Lord is taking him places. And that's why the Lord has given him this vision of this London Mission Christian Center. And I'm optimistic that the Lord will do wonders in this ministry. So I may, tell you, if we can rise up for the man of God, for the honor of the man of God,
today is meant to be together with his wife, and I'm sure they are going to tell us more, and God bless you. Thank you.
I'm just a shy boy from Central Province. My mother raised me up by picking coffee, and I'm just humbled. Praise God. Shall we take our seat, please? Can I request all my colleagues to come in front? All my colleague, all the pastors. If you are a pastor, just try to the ushers to give the pastors front seats, please. Give honor to whom that is due. Praise God. Why don't you shake your hand of your neighbor and tell your neighbor, I'm glad again you're here. It's nice to see all of you, Gordon, Mr. Mwaura, Pastor Izichuku, Pastor Angaruro, Pastor Kihara. Wow, Minister Harris, Pastor Boni, Mr. Seed. God bless you, all of you. Praise God. Shake your neighbor and tell your neighbor, Pastor Anthony has really welcomed you into this place. If you see a pastor there, ushers, please help them out and bring them in front here. God bless you so much. I want to start with just giving a little speech, and the Lord will bless all of us. I want to say that to God be all the glory. To God be all the glory. Our distinguished guests, friends of the ministry, partners in this great work, family friends, representative of various churches and charities, my fellow colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, allow me to convey my indebtedness on this great and memorable occasion where we all come to witness the opening and the launching of London Mission Christian Center. Which I will further on refer in this speech as LMCC. This is a dream come true. History will never give you a chance to repeat. And we believe that this is history in the making. In this great work is a sign that we are not alone in this. For the last 1 year, a lot of care has been given to ensure that this day will be a success. Prayers, planning, petitions, and finances have been rendered to keep the vision afloat. Last week, our church, which was our home for almost 5 years, laid hands on us and commissioned us to come and start this great work. What can I say? I am very, very humbled by God. Dear friends, today LMCC officially become a functioning church. We would like to be seen as a complementary, but not as a competitor. LMCC will be a house of God open to all nations and races. It will be a house of prayer, a family church, a mission-oriented church, where limitless praise and worship shall be given. We trust in this house that signs and wonders shall take place. We are praying that it will, and we endeavor to be a Bible-believing-based church, a church where both adults and children will be treated with sincere dignity. LMCC seek to remain accountable and transparent to her mission. We trust that we will work as a team and not a one-man band. Not a one-man band. A church that will change generation even as Christ tarries. Above all, LMCC will seek to enrich you so that you may reach others. Hence our mission statement, enriching you to reach others. Turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, enriching you to reach others. And With that few remarks, I want us to open our Bibles in the book of Matthew chapter 16. It's a parable of a master who was supposedly rich. And I want to presume and I want to believe, according to my Bible study, that this master was God himself. He did four hiring. The first hiring was very early in the morning. The second hiring was 9 a.m. The third was 12 a.m. or 12 p.m. The fourth was 3 p.m. And the last one was 5 p.m. Now, those are five hiring, and number five in the Bible is a number of grace. Tell your neighbor, it's a number of grace. No wonder the Bible says that the grace of God has appeared to all men. Nobody cannot say that the grace of God has not appeared to me. Now, the aspect of hiring laborers in this passage is a continuous reminder that the harvest is ripe, but the laborers are a few. That's why the master kept on hiring people. Very early in the morning, 9 a.m., 12 p.m., 3 p.m., and 5 p.m. And you wonder, why should master keep hiring people even when it's only 1 hour remaining? Because the master does not care. He wants his work to be finished. Praise God. In Matthew chapter 9, verse 37 and 38, the Bible says that, look, the harvest is ripe, but the laborers are a few. Pray for the God of the harvest to bring the laborers. Tell your neighbor, you are a laborer. I know some of you are not doing much in your churches, but let me tell you, God is calling people from all walks, to come and work in his vineyard. I told you my synopsis of where I've come from. My mother has raised me by coffee picking. Later on in life, she was making changa until the grace of God appeared to us. If there is anyone there who does not understand changa, then you better explain to them what is changa. But the grace of God appeared to us in our family. And here we are. We are a co-laborers together with you and them. Praise God. Now the Bible says in Matthew chapter 20 verse 6, he asked them, why are you standing here all day long? And they answered him, verse 7, because we have got no one to hire us. Verse 7b, he said, you also go and work in my vineyard. Touch your neighbor and tell your neighbor, you also. These men had no title, they had no qualification, they had no charisma, but the master told them, you also, instead of staying here idle, go and work. This is why for years, 10 years I've been in this country, the Lord told me last year in June, you also go and set up London Mission Christian Center. You also. Praise God. Let me tell you, to say that I'm excited is an understatement. This is my memorable day. I was telling my wife, I will not die until I see this day. Praise God. Tell your neighbor, you will not die until you see the works of God. Not one work, but many works. Praise God. Some of you, I know you are thinking that you have come to an end, but let me tell you, the battle has just begun. You will not die. Praise God. I say, praise God. He said, go ye and also work in my vineyard. I know some of you in modern era, we could have said, I've got no NI, I've got no P60, I've got no good reference, I don't have much resume. I used to call it resume. Praise God. I don't have much resume, but the master said, you also, irrespective of your circumstances, go and work in my vineyard. Isn't our God wonderful? God is in the business of hiring you and me. Praise God. I say, praise God. You know, some of you would have said, oh, my wife, she doesn't, you know, buy this idea of being a pastor. Some of you would have said, oh, my children, I don't want them to be PK, pastor's kids. I know some of you would say, oh, my husband, I don't know how he's going to misinterpret my walk with God. Let me tell you, the master, when he calls you, he will take care of all your worries. Tell your neighbor, chill. Tell your neighbor, chill. The Bible says that in a big house, there are vessels of all, there are articles not only of gold and silver, but also of wood and clay. The Bible goes on to say, some are of noble use, others are of ignoble use. Now, in verse number 21, the Bible says that, but if any man, which is gender neutral, if any man, women are also included, children are also included, if any man, tell your neighbor, you are also included. The Bible says that if any man cleanses himself for the latter, it doesn't matter whether you are of clay or of wood. But if you cleanse yourself, you say, Lord, here I am, and I'm available. The Bible says that he will be an instrument. Tell your neighbor, you are an instrument. Now, mark you, the development of this text is moving from article. The Bible starts with an article. God changes you from an article to be an instrument. Praise God. The other day, a girl sent me an instrument from UK. She's in Kenya. It was this calculator. They call it Texas Instrument. When this girl sent this instrument, asked me to buy this instrument, I thought it was just a calculator. But it has moved from a calculator to an instrument. I was asked to pay almost 160 quid. And I asked the guy who was selling, are you sure this is the same a calculator you used to calculate them days? He said, this is an instrument. God is moving you from an article to an instrument. Just because you are available for him to use you. Tell your neighbor once again, you are an instrument for God to use you. I know some of you, you can look at your history, you look at your background, you look at your pedigree. I tell people, don't ask me my family background. It began when I gave my life to Jesus Christ. I came from a backgroundless family. Some people ask me, oh, how about your family tree? It was cut even before I was born. Praise the name of the Lord. And that's where we began. Praise God. If such a person who is wood or clay, people of low esteem, avail themselves for the master to use them, let me tell you, even the media will hound them. They will hound them because God will make them an expensive instrument. Tell your neighbor, you think you are cheap? Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. Now listen, the Bible says that in the book of Ephesians 2:10. The Bible says that for we are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for every good work. I want you to notice these four processes. Number one, we must be in the house of God. For God to make you an instrument, you must be in his house. He is not raising people outside the house, but he is raising people inside the house. Number two, we should not allow our description to hinder us to be used by God. Some of you, I know some mean words have been spoken over your life when you were growing up. A teacher maybe somewhere said something about your life. Somehow maybe even your grandfather, for those who have been raised by their grandfathers and their grandmothers, you are called some names. Eh? Some names that depict four-legged animal. Don't worry, praise God. Because God is still changing that. Praise God. So don't worry your description to hinder you to be used by God, because God is in the business of hiring you and me. Praise God. Tell your neighbor, I think that is wonderful. Number three, we must avail ourselves to be used by God. We must avail ourselves to be used by God. When the prophet were asked, who is there that I may send? The Bible says that Isaiah stood up and said, here I am, Lord. Send me. For 10 years I've been resisting this. But all of a sudden I said, God, you are too much. You are too much. You are too much. I say, Lord, use me. We must be availing ourselves. We must avail ourselves. We must avail our children. We must. The other day my child was given a toy in the McDonald's. A toy that was singing Beyonce song. And Beyonce was saying, I'm the best girl in the world. And my son was kind of singing the lyric. I say, son, she is not the best. Praise God. She is not the best because she's not in Christ. Praise the name of the Lord. Because I must avail my children to be used by God, but not by the world. Praise God. And number four, there should be no idleness in the house of God. There should be no idleness. Tell your neighbor, do not be idle. When you give your life to Jesus Christ, the first 3 months, you must turn to your pastor and ask your pastor, what can I do? The Bible says that whatever your hand findeth, what will make Christendom or the Christian church to progress is by people removing their hands from their pocket. Praise God. We don't want people who are going to just come and, you know, for people who work with me, I will stretch you to the limit. Because I know you are elastic. Tell your neighbor, you are elastic. Praise God. Because I know God want to use you. You cannot afford to be idle in the house. Jesus asked them, Mr. Mwaura, we were with you in this world. He asked them, why are you sitting here? We have got no one to hire us. He was told, go, you also, go. There is no explanation. Jesus knew they are going to give. Pastor Kasuvu, please, Pastor Kasuvu, come forward. I was really waiting for him. Why don't we put our hands together upon these ministers of God who are coming in? So you also, go and work in my vineyard. Friends, why should we be idle? Why should we be idle? There are some people who are perishing. We cannot afford to be idle. It took the grace of God to bring somebody alongside your life so that you may give your life to Jesus Christ. We cannot afford to be idle. I got a number of excuses, but as a human being, I said, Lord, they could be genuine excuses. Praise God. But for you who have come, clap for yourself. Now the Bible says that the master of the banquet said, this party must go on irrespective. Go. He asked him. Mr. Seed, he told him, go in the streets and in the lanes. But the Lord told me, there are people who are going to hell on the highway of hell nonstop, and he has given me power and authority to stop them. Praise the name of the Lord. Now I started to argue with the Lord and I said, God, how about if one madman lands on me? He said, son, a policeman may not have power over a 24-ton lorry, but he has got authority. Praise God. I've given you both power and authority. Whoever you wave down, they will come down. They will stop in the hard shoulder of the gospel. Praise the name of the Lord. In this London, we have got more than 50 million people who live in this London. The biggest church is only 13,000 people. Praise God. That means there are so many people there in this highway that we need to stop. Praise the name of the Lord. I told you I will not speak more than 20 minutes. On Sunday, I will preach my song out. Praise God. Tell your neighbor, it is your time also. When the Lord spoke to me about the church, I looked all over and I said, I need somebody who will tell me what is going on in my life. And I looked and I searched and I found one man of God that we met by coincidence. And he told me, Pastor Anthony, you are pregnant. Me, pregnant? He said, the way you have explained to me, you are behaving like a pregnant woman. And you need to take care of that baby. And for 9 months, my midwife has been guiding me. And I am happy that he is here. I want to invite him to come and officially help me and help the leadership of London Mission Center, together with our colleagues, to come and cut the ribbon and usher the prayer of dedication to the ministry. Is none other than Pastor Steve Kasuvu from JRC in North Holt. Put your hands together as the man of God and his wife comes in the podium. Pastor Naomi, also.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. The Bible says in Ecclesiastes 3:1, there is a season and a time for every purpose under heaven. Down there, it says he has made everything beautiful, not in his time, but in its time. And I believe this is the time. I want you to shake the hands of your neighbors and tell them this is the time for LMCC to be born. Hallelujah. And therefore, we are not going to spend a lot of time, because I know we are supposed to be out of here by 5. I want all of us to be on our feet as we honor God who has given this great vision. Hallelujah. And I would request the wife to join us. Praise the Lord.
I want you to put your hands together and celebrate the woman of God. Come on, put your hands together and celebrate this woman. Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together and celebrate the pastor's wife. Glory to God. You know, sometimes we celebrate the anointed man of God. We celebrate the great visionary. But you don't know the work we do behind the scene. We celebrate, we honor the man of God like now, Pastor Kimani, everybody is celebrating you. But let me tell you, without this woman, come on, somebody. And I want to speak in just in 2 minutes. The people that God is going to ordain to come and be part of this vision. Even when you don't understand this woman, just pray for her. I'm telling you, being the pastor's wife is the greatest commission I have ever seen. You have to smile from January to January. You have to be happy, never believe. It is a calling by itself. But one thing I know, though the sorrows may be great, but the joys cannot be compared. Amen. I'm so honored today to be part of what God is going to do through you guys. May the Lord continue to enrich you. May the Lord continue to give you more strength. When times of shake-ups come, stick together. You know, stand with your husband. Even when you don't understand him, stand with him. May the Lord bless you as you begin this great journey. Amen.
Hallelujah. I will ask the servants of God who are here, please, if you can just step forward and let's surround this place as we cut the ribbon. All the pastors, all the ministers of the gospel, please come forward and let's do it together in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Come over here. Let's do it together. We will look back a time coming and we shall thank God for what he did this very day. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. 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 Just squeeze yourself somewhere and let's do it together. Hallelujah.
We are just going to honor God. We are going to tell the Lord he deserves all the glory and all the adoration. Just in a few minutes. You deserve the glory. Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we lift your holy hands. You deserve the glory and the
worship you. We give you all the glory and all the honor. Father, we worship you. We give you all the praise. We declare that great works will follow this vision. We worship you, for you are such a faithful God. We celebrate your glory today. As we lay down, my God and my Redeemer, we celebrate what you are doing today. Somebody open your mouth and celebrate the Lord. We worship him. We give him all the glory. He's worthy to be glorified. We worship him. Father, we thank you. You are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, oh God. Father, we declare that you are beginning of this vision. We declare that everlasting Father, the good work that you have begun in their lives, oh God, you will surely bring it to pass until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name we agree together. Amen.
Hallelujah. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I want to say that it is an honor and privilege this very day, the 5th of June 2011. I want to declare that in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, London Mission Christian Center is officially open. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus! Thank you, Jesus! Thank you, Jesus! We celebrate your goodness! We celebrate your favor! We celebrate your goodness! We celebrate your power! Glorious Lord, we thank you!
He's a mighty God! He's a mighty Jehovah! He's a mighty God!
He's a mighty
Lord Jehovah! He's a mighty God!
He's a mighty God!
We are praising the mighty God!
He's a mighty
God! We are praising the mighty God!
He's a mighty
God! We are dancing to the mighty God!
Lord
Jehovah is a mighty God!
He's a mighty
Jehovah! Is a mighty God! We are celebrating the mighty God! We are dancing to the mighty God!
He's a mighty God!
Everybody bow before him!
He's a mighty God!
I say everybody bow before him!
He's a mighty God!
The demons bow before him!
He's a mighty God!
Put your hands together! Come on, put your hands together! Put your hands together! He's a mighty God!
He's a mighty
Jehovah! He's a mighty God!
He's a mighty
God! We are praising the mighty God!
He's a mighty God!
We are celebrating the mighty God!
He's a mighty God!
We are dancing to the mighty God!
He's a mighty God!
We are dancing to the mighty God!
He's a mighty God!
We are celebrating the mighty God!
He's a mighty God!
We are moving and bowing before you!
He's a mighty God!
I say woman bound before you,
he's a mighty God.
Oh, I am Krishna bound before you,
he's a mighty God.
I am Krishna bound before you,
he's a mighty God.
Come on, put your hands together. Yes! Bless them! We declare you are blessed!
blessed. We declare you are blessed. We declare you are blessed. We declare you are blessed. Come and bless them. Bless them.
Joy, I want you to take 2 minutes to bless the servants of God and the work that has just begun. I want you to stretch your hands towards them and speak words of blessing. Speak, speak. There is life in your tongue. Speak. What would you want to see? What would you want to hear about the work of God? Speak it with your tongue in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. Father, we worship you. Thank you, Lord God Almighty, for bringing this great work and our time of bringing forth. Lord, I thank you. Blessed be your holy name. What a great beginning. What a miracle. What a blessing. We thank you and we magnify your holy name. Give the glory. We honor thee. Thank you for your faithfulness. Thank you for your grace. Thank you. Be thou glorified. Be thou glorified. Hallelujah. I want you to hold the hand of the person next to you as we agree together in prayer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's agree together. Our heavenly precious Father, we thank you for this precious moment when we have witnessed London Mission Christian Center being born. Oh, we give you the glory, we give you the praise. Mighty and everlasting Father, we are not ignorant of the devices of the enemy, and therefore we take power and authority against the priest that is in charge of Dagenham. In the name of Jesus, we come against all the powers of darkness that have been fighting the churches, that have been fighting the ministries, that have been fighting the work of God. Right now we take power and authority in the name of Jesus. We come against you by the blood of Jesus, and we declare the judgment fire of God against you in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we stand on the word of God. Jesus said, I shall build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. We declare in the name of Jesus, the gates of hell shall not prevail. We declare strife will not prevail. Segregation will not prevail. Hatred will not prevail. Any kind of attack will not prevail. In the name of Jesus, financial challenges will not prevail. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, witchcraft will not prevail. Every arrow of the enemy will not prevail. In the name of Jesus. Now we ask your favor, that you will give your servants favor with every nationality in this city. In the name of Jesus, we pray that you will give them favor with the leaders in this city. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord God, I pray that you will supply the workers to run with the vision. In the name of Jesus, we call workers from the north. We call workers from the south. We call workers from the west. We call workers from the east in the name of Jesus, and we declare there will be enough manpower to one with a vision, in the name of Jesus, I declare there will be enough wisdom, there will be enough anointing, there will be enough grace to do the work of God, in the name of Jesus.
I pray that God, you will bring loyal men, committed men, men with the zeal of God, men with the fear of God, to come and submit themselves under them, in the mighty name of Jesus. King of glory, we are declaring progress, we are declaring increase, we are declaring multiplication, in the name of Jesus. We are declaring this church will not close down, in the name of Jesus. We delete your name from the list of those who close down, in the name of Jesus. And we put a name in the list of those who will thrive, those which will continue to get stronger and stronger, in the name of Jesus. Oh, thank you. But those who will come and submit themselves under the servants of God, they will never be disappointed, in the name of Jesus. For you will show yourself strong and able on their behalf, to the glory and honor of your name. We call people of all ages, children, the youth, couples, singles, every age, we call them to this vision, in the name of Jesus. And we thank you that already you have supplied, that already the victory is there. We honor you and we thank you. We look forward to hear great testimonies, signs and wonders shall follow this ministry, in the name of Jesus. We thank you and we worship you. For this we ask, and it is in Jesus' name, amen. And we call it done.
Yeah. Prophetic. We need to hear that at this moment. We have our mother in the house. We have known this lady for a longer time. Since we have come into this country, they are the people and their friends. They welcomed and made us feel free in this country. So we want to give her this privilege to mark this communion as we enter into what God has called us. Welcome, ma'am.
Praise the Lord. Amen. I'm privileged to stand before you, and I won't take much time, but I'm going to cut the cake. Hallelujah. To mark the anniversary of a new baby who is going to be born, who is already born, because we are in a labor word, aren't we? You know. The baby has already been born. Praise God. So are we celebrating or are we?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Let me cut the cake. Praise God. Amen.
My God is good.
My God is good.
My God is good.
Ain't not double,
my God, go double,
ain't not double,
My name is Esther Wanja, or Mama Catherine. She is Catherine. And as Joshua said, myself and my house will serve the Lord. Amen? Amen. I'm just so grateful to be here today. Pastors in the house, women and men of God, I mean, every one of you, may God bless you. I'm just so excited, grateful, and I'm just so thankful to the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
DJ number 6, please. Hallelujah. And if you know that it is God doing it, rise up and help me sing.
I'm gonna make it.
bless you. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's give a big clap for our sister and the wonderful song that she has sung, that it is the Lord's doing. It is no one's doing. And now we want to take this opportunity to thank each and every one of you for coming. We are very grateful. We appreciate you. We do apologize. As you heard, it is the first baby. Next time, we'll consider the time of fellowship and moving on. But at this time, you have to excuse us. Amen. And please love us. And when we invite you, please come again. We make sure that we allocate more time to fellowship together. If you did not get a piece of cake, please don't worry. Because on your way out, we make sure you have one. Please, we want to make sure that you, once the ushers give you a pack of food, feel free. If the weather has changed, if it's not the way we left it, we can go behind the park and sit down and have your picnic with your family and in your own. Hallelujah. But we are very, very grateful. Tell your neighbor, we are happy that you came. And LMCC appreciates you. Amen. Amen. God bless you so much. We have another friend, a longtime friend. We want to welcome him to Wired with the Word of Prayer. And we are very, very grateful. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless your family. May the Lord bless your ministry, the ministers of God. We are very grateful for the time that you have allocated to come and see the doings of the Lord. Those who have come from far, from Nottingham, Bristol, Manchester, wherever you have come from, feel that you have been appreciated. And if it was for us, we could have given you a chance to come and bless us. But next time, there is always a chance. May the Lord bless you. Amen.
It's my joy and privilege to bring the proceedings to an end and to pray. You know, John had a revelation, didn't he, of the lamb that was slain. And he said, "You are worthy, for you have purchased by your blood from every kindred, tribe, and tongue, and people, and nation, to be priests and kings to our God." And that's what we've been doing this afternoon. And I want you all to stand with me. Let's pray for this new work. Let's pray a blessing on Antony and Caroline, their family, on Patrick, on this work of the gospel, in Jesus' name. Yeah, Jesus, you said, "I will build my church and the gates of hell will not prevail." I thank you, Lord Jesus, that you have moved in the hearts of Antony and Caroline, of Patrick, all those here, Lord God, to see a work raised up in this place, to preach the gospel, Lord, to see the captives freed, to see lives put together again, to see broken hearts mended. We thank you, Lord Jesus. We pray for the children that will come into this place, that they will be blessed by your Holy Spirit. They will grow and in every way become men and women of God. We pray for every aspect of pastoral care that will take place in this place. May your Holy Spirit so fill the leadership and the workers here. Lord, bring in those who are filled with your Spirit and with a heart to work for your gospel in this place. Yeah, we pray in the name of Jesus. Let the Holy Spirit fill this church, fill this place. Let there be an anointing on Antony, on Caroline, on Patrick, for your work. In Jesus' name, amen. And thank you all so very, very much.
Hold the hand of your neighbor and let us say the benediction together. I want to invite you on Sunday. We will be worshiping here in Castle Green. Our ushers will be on the door to receive you on Sunday. If you go to your church, please keep on going to your church. If you don't have a home, that you can make your spiritual home. You are welcome, more than welcome. We love you and we will cherish you and train you and raise you up in the fear of the Lord. I've got no words but to say how sweet you are. May the blessings of the Lord be with you. May his face shine upon you. May camels and donkeys and the abundance of the rubies of this world meet you even before you ask it. Now and forevermore. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Please feel free to mingle just outside. Let us just meet outside completely as you pick your food. Feel free to greet the servants of God who are around here. Yeah, feel free to greet them. Pastor Jerona, Pastor Wangaruro, all of them. Just feel free, Pastor Karanja, feel free to mingle with them. My friends from Haru, the Lord bless you so much. I have got no word than to say the Lord bless you, and bless you sweetly. In Jesus' name, amen. For those people who are asking about the standing order on how to support the ministry, feel free to call us. Feel free to call us and we will support you generously. God bless. Bye.